Welcome to the video. I'm gonna try to keep this one short because the things in the meat of the video are really important. So you should make sure to check all of it out. I consider it one of the best videos I've ever made. So hopefully you enjoy and thank you, Sam. Post your comments and thoughts in the chat down below, and we can talk about it.
So I just got cut from my high school baseball team, senior year varsity. And I just thought I'd share this with everyone. I don't care whether it's politics or whatever it is that anyone wants to say. You know, people like to claim something about politics all the time. And in my head, I try to ignore that because it's not really politics. It's natural. It's what people do. If politics is everywhere. I still don't worry about it because it's nothing I can control. Like, I'll only worry about the shit that I can control. But, like, when you think about it, really, don't, like, you gotta be self-aware about where you're actually at. Like, people tend to think, like, they really tend to overthink about where they really are. Not overthink, but they tend to overhype themselves. Like, I really thought that I was, like, something really good or whatever. Just, I really thought I was good. But then I get cut, and I actually realize now, these guys are either just as good as me and they're juniors and I'm a whole year behind, or they're better than me. And that's not good either. None of those are good. Neither of those are good. And keep in mind, I've been training all offseason. All offseason. One of the hardest trainers, one of the biggest improvements, and I'm still not good enough to be on this team. It's high school, okay? It's not college, it's not pros, it's not like independent ball, it's none of that. It's high school. And my expectations were set here, which are probably compared, like, it's just slightly above. High school is slightly higher than that. I need to raise my expectations the way some of y'all need to raise your expectations. Because you put the same limitations on yourself, and whatever you put in your head, those are what you're limited to. Saying that, the odds of you making college are very low. Like, just like, I've heard that shit so many times, but if you just raise your expectations, college is nothing. College is still nothing. The same way, pro ball is still just games. It's still just games. Raise your expectations. Raise what you expect from yourself because you deserve the best. You put in the most. You should be not wasting your time. You're too high value for that shit. All of us are. So in the future, I know this shit hurts, okay? I'm recording this now because I could not do it before. I would not be able to do it before. I literally just got cut 2 hours ago, and I haven't coped with it. I can't say that I have. It's one of the harder things I ever thought I'd have to deal with because I haven't played. I got cut sophomore year too. And you guys, I'm not just some fucking kid chasing like something that I'll never have. I'm not like, it's not like that, okay? I actually am putting the work in. I'm making myself better every single day. I'm competing. I compete with those guys. I'm that close to that being that better. I'm that close to being better than those guys. What I can't control is my height. Okay, like these things, the genetics of it, I can't control. So I have no issues worrying about that. I have no, like, that is out of my mind. I don't care about that. Call it politics, call it whatever, call it height, whatever it is. It doesn't matter. It does not matter. We all need to raise our expectations at some point in life. You didn't get the job, fine, whatever, fuck it. Raise your expectations to something better. Create your own job, okay? Stop making excuses. And this is the real shit I'll actually be able to put on here, okay? Because I really can't put things into words without there being a prompt or something to give me to feed on. This right here is so easy. It's so simple. Just raise your expectations. Make things harder so that when it comes to the real shit, it's that much easier. You trained up here, but in reality, it's down here, okay? You train here, and you train 90, 95, but in game, it's 80, 85, 85, 85. And this shit right here looks like nothing compared to 95. Or whatever, the speed that you were seeing off the bat when you were training in the outfield, whatever it was, when you were pushing yourself to the limits, learning about stocks, whatever it was, like, all this new shit, you learn all the time. You should be learning all the time and not making excuses. Excuses put you so far behind in the world. You guys, I hope all of y'all learn a lesson about this shit that's just like time wasting, right? You're all just on a path. We're all just on a path of being better versions of ourselves. And I trust that that God upstairs, whether you believe in him or not, I trust that I'm going to be on his path. And no matter what happens, and this cut, being cut right here, I could have absolutely not gotten past it. I could have thrown everything away. I could have really just completely changed everything. But right now, it's getting easier. As I'm talking to you guys, I'm starting to just realize the reality of it. Like, yeah, I'm going to be on this path, right? It's a path. And I really wanted to be on this varsity team so I could shove it up some people's ass. It would have been so good. But it's just not meant to be. It's not meant to be. And now I'm about to have one of the best fucking seasons coming out of high school. And then I'm going to go and try and play for MATC. The odds are stacked against me. But guys, y'all root for the underdog, right? We all root for the underdog. Y'all best root for me. It's coming, all right? I'm going to be all over this shit. And if I'm not, if y'all are not over all over your shit, if y'all don't completely and 100% take advantage of where you're at and be 100% into it, you're losing. Everyone else is going to be winning. You have to raise your expectations, okay? Everyone's a dog. Everyone's a dog in this world. And they're all just going to take shit from you. Nobody gives a fuck, okay? Everyone's in it to get the best for themselves. So why aren't you? If you're not, why aren't you? Alright guys, I'll talk to you later. Maybe this will be the end of the video. I'm not sure. But if it is, I hope y'all enjoyed. Comment back. Let's get some feedback going, alright? Let's talk about this shit. See y'all later.
Thought of something else, guys, while I've been driving here. I was just picking up food from my parents and family. Self-improvement is huge. I talk about a couple of main things. Self-improvement, self-awareness, and honestly, you're gonna have to like bring it out of me to figure out the other one, but like I do have a couple main things like that. And self-improvement allows you to make those types of decisions that, you know, most people aren't strong enough to make. Respect comes from self-improvement, honestly, in my opinion. You respect yourself more having improved in your own eyes. Your eyes, you look at yourself in the mirror different. Like everything you see is, you see a different version of yourself when you respect yourself. And, you know, the more you can be consistent in being the type of person that you want to be, it doesn't matter as much what other people think or what other people do, because all that matters is that you continue those main things. You keep doing what gets you happiness, what makes you who you are. Keep being that person, because honestly, that's what everybody, that's what you need, that's what you want. That's gonna work for you. Keep self-improving. Don't let these fucking minor things just affect you so much. And there's just no reason. There's no reason for these things to affect you like that. Yeah, I just made a shitty driving choice, but it's okay. But anyways, guys, the more I get it, the more I see it, I'll keep posting these little videos like this, because there's just so much to take in about the world and little lessons to learn. But if we all just like start seeing the world for what it is and just trying to learn lessons, because that's what it's about. I can't remember which basketball player said it, but I think it might have been Kobe, honestly. But he would look at kids as a younger age, and he would learn off of what other people did. I think that was actually Michael Jordan, actually. That way he didn't make the same mistake twice. You're a fool if you make another mistake that someone else already made. So continue to learn, continue to see things and be a better version of yourself by doing those things, by learning, by continuing to grow and never settling. Because in this world, no one is ever perfect. No one is ever the best version of themselves. Let's be honest here. We can all always strive to be better at some point in our lives. It doesn't matter if you're 60. It doesn't matter if you're 30. It's all relative, okay? You can be the best 60-year-old version of yourself possible. That's what it's about. And what it's about is always being better than you were the day before. No matter where you start, whenever you look at it, you start and you continue to grow. That's all. I mean, honestly, like every single day should be positive. You gotta win the day. I'll talk about that too. Winning the day is huge. It's about productivity.
winning the day is like, if you won the morning, right? Let's say you lifted in the morning, right? I would say you won the morning. Let's say you didn't have that snack, you won the afternoon. But then you fucked up all night long. All night long, you had that midnight snack, you had all that shit. You lost. Did you really win the day if you could, if you lost so big? If you lost so big, but you won all the morning, all the afternoon, does it really make you a winner? No, you want to be a winner. We're all striving to be winners. We all want to win. All right, that's the competition in us. That's nature. We want that. We're all striving to be competitive, right? Or, well, not. We're all trying to be competitive. We're all trying to compete. That's just natural, guys. That's how the shit is. All right, guys. That's what I got. I don't got much else. So, yeah. I'll try and add some new shit in, but, I'll see you guys soon. Screaming money, counting chains, clanking shit. I guess that's how it sound when you winning. I ain't joking, do it sound like I'm kidding. I've been making like 2,000 a minute. So high up through the clouds, I was swimming. I'm probably gonna drown when I'm in it. I bet she gonna get loud when I'm in it. And we might have a child. I don't love a hoe after we fuck, she can't get near me. Only bitch I give a conversation to a Siri. My pants are Mary. Yes, I'm winning clearly. I'm the chosen one, see my potential, so they fear me. Lately, I've been praying, God, I wonder, can you hear me?